From best-selling authors to entertainers, entrepreneurs and business leaders, Dr. Amantha Imber spends her days delving deep into the habits and strategies of the world's most successful people.
Now, she's sharing their secrets in her new book, Timewise. It's full of advice on finding more hours in your day, and I'm pleased to say she joins us this morning to share some of those secrets. Amantha, great to have you on the program. First off, you reckon most of us have got goal setting all wrong. What are we doing wrong?
What we're doing wrong is simply setting goals. So goal setting is inherently broken because we are failing until we hit the goal. So take, for example, a weight loss goal. I want to lose 10 kilos, let's say. But until we lose those 10 kilos, we are failing because we haven't hit that goal. And so what I found in Timewise is that some of the world's most successful people actually set systems instead of goals. So they might set the system, a daily system of doing half an hour of exercise or eating 5 serves of vegetables a day. And through setting and sticking to that daily system, we actually get to that end point without constantly feeling like we're failing.
Mm. And social media, that can really help us feel like we're failing in life as well, especially, you know, you can spend hours, you know, mindless scrolling. So what have you got? You've got some tips for us on that.
I have. So certainly a lot of the entrepreneurs and other successful people that I spoke to for the book Timewise is that one of the quirkiest tips I've heard actually came from Kevin Rose, who is a very successful venture capitalist in Silicon Valley, invested in companies like Facebook and Twitter. Something that he wanted to do is reduce the amount of time he was just mindlessly picking up his mobile phone, as I'm sure we're all guilty of. Many of us do it hundreds of times a day. And Kevin was doing it 100 times a day, and he wanted to reduce that. So what he did, this is very simple, he tied a rubber band around his phone so that whenever he picked up his phone, he would have to remove that rubber band in order to unlock it and do some scrolling. And what he found is that it made him think more consciously about his mobile phone use, and he actually reduced his daily pickups from 100 per day to just 30 per day.
That's a big drop, isn't it?
Find some rubber bands. Yeah. You've written there's a difference between difficult and unpleasant decisions. How does knowing that difference help make them?
Well, I got this tip from Phil Libin, who's the founder of Evernote, which is very popular note-taking software. And he said that often with decision-making, we can spend a lot of time on decisions that feel very hard. But what's important is to actually ask yourself, is this a complex decision, one that is actually hard to make, or is it one that is just unpleasant, that we're kind of resisting making, but we actually know the right answer? Mm. And so the trick with decision making is to, when you've got a hard decision to make, ask yourself, is this just an unpleasant decision that I'm resisting making but wasting a lot of time on? And if it is, just make the decision. But if it is truly a complex or complicated decision, then do invest more time in making it.
What about the to-do list? Because we all like a to-do list to help us get through life, but you're a fan of the to-don't list.
I am. So, I mean, I feel like life can just be about adding more and more things to our to-do list. But a tip that I learned from Rachel Botsman, who's a world-renowned expert on trust and technology, is that she has a to-don't list. And she adds to it every month, and she thinks about what are the things from the month just past that have really sucked my energy and made my life a bit worse. And she puts that on her to-don't list. And I've certainly created my own to-don't list. For example, I don't check emails first thing because I know that if I do that, I just start my day off to just be reacting to what everybody else wants. And so instead, I'll do something else with my mornings that doesn't involve email or social media.
Great idea. Hey, anxiety plays a huge part at the moment, particularly in chasing success. Mm. You've spoken to the successful people. How do they handle that?
A really good tip that I got for facing our fears, and I got this one from Michelle Poehler, and something that she found, she set a project where she faced 100 fears in 100 days. And often when you're facing a fear, like maybe going skydiving, for example, or doing a presentation, which can be quite scary, people ask you, what's the worst that could happen? But I mean, in the case of something like skydiving, the worst that could happen is you could die.
Pretty
and
bad.
That's terrible, right? And so instead, she found a much more helpful question to ask was, what's the best that could happen? Because that gets you in touch with your motivation in terms of why am I doing this really hard, scary thing in the first place?